Hello everyone, welcome back to Divay Miglani classes. Today what we are going to talk about is securities law and capital market. Securities law and capital market, yes, it's altogether a new subject for you guys. Sir, you have changed a lot this and this. Yes, I know. It's not that technical one, it's still original one. Now talking about the topic, we do have what we are going to talk about is securities law and capital market. So talking about securities law, what is security? Security is something which we have covered into our company law, talking about section 2 subsection H of SCRA, Securities Contract Regulation Act 1956. Yes, so that was the definition of security, which do include a lot of things. So how that securities will be regulated, this is all about securities law, and how the market will be regulated, that is all about capital market. Kuch nahi samajh mein. Okay, now moving on to the topic itself. That what we are going to talk about, that you must have seen a lot of people who used to trade, who used to deal with stock exchanges, the people who are dealing at stock exchanges, the people who are selling shares, they are buying shares every time. So you let me give you an example. You do have a person in your neighbor whose name is Rambabu. Rambabu is a person who used to trade, or who used to do every day trading, that can be intraday, that can be intraday trading on that kind of stock exchanges. He do have a demat account, he do have everything. So what does this Rambabu basically, what is the things which are required to be carried out? So Rambabu particularly purchases shares of a company. Rambabu is going to purchase the shares of a company. He will purchase shares of a company. And after some time, when he will find that yes, if he has purchased the shares of the company at ₹1,000, they have moved on to ₹1,500, Rambabu will sell it. Rambabu will sell it. If he is going to sell, now you are not required to look over here. My dear future company secretary, you will be standing over here. You are somehow over here who is going to regulate this sale and this purchase, this buy and sell relationship. Definitely the shares are never sold through any of the OLX, or they are not sold like share lelo, 100 rupee, no. There is nothing like ki bhindi bik rahi hai bazaar ke andar, no. I mean nobody is going to shout like 100 rupees. The other person will say like, no, 90 rupees per kg. No, that is not going to be there like that. Now in that kind of situation, there will be a person who is going to regulate all these kind of situations when it comes to purchase and sale of shares. So talking about this person has purchased shares, can I say it like just shares are a part of security? Yes, shares are a part of security. Security section 2 subsection H of SCRA 1956, which includes so many things. Now, my dear future company secretary, can you please tell me one thing? That this buy and sell, this takes place at the stock exchange, if I'm not wrong. Yes, and if we talk about today, we do have only two kind of stock exchanges which are available, dynamic and designated, that is NSE and BSE only. So the very first is NSE and then it's BSE, right? These are the two kind of stock exchanges which are available. Now the people who are going to be over here, the people who are going to take care of those kind of things, who are going to be there, they are going to look after a lot of laws. It looks too simple because you are looking from the investor's point of view, right? You're looking from the investor's point of view, but when it comes to a company, if a company wants to go for buyback, then there are certain different implications. Or let me give you the very simple scenario. If you want to go for an IPO or you want to go for an FPO, right? You want to go for an IPO or you want to go for an IPO, just like your wedding is going on. Everybody is going to come. They are going to subscribe. They are going to eat in your wedding. And after that, they are going to pay for that. They will give you an amount known as gift. The IPO and FPO, that the same scenario carries on, being like that, yes, it's a wedding going on. The people are going to subscribe, they are going to have the chicken, they are going to have, if that is a vegetarian wedding, then definitely they are going to have shai paneer. Right. So in that kind of scenarios, everybody, they are going to subscribe. And after that, they are going to F. They will be getting proper food. They will give you a gift. If in case you went to a particular wedding and what you find that everything is over, will you give them something as a part of gift? No, sir. I mean, मैं तो कतई ली चढ़ूँ, मैं तो सीधा वापस आ जाऊँ, खाने को नहीं मिला तेरे को पैसे काहे को दूँ. 95% of people in India, 95% are there in wedding just for their dinners, just to have their dinners. That's it. So talking about IPO, FPO, buyback, delisting. So we will be also talking about that this company, this buy and this purchase and sell of shares takes place at stock exchange. Why not any other place? Why stock exchange? Because the company is listed on that stock exchange. You can buy shares from that place. You can sell shares from that place depending upon that. If, let me give you one more scenario. If a company is listed, then definitely Ram Babu can purchase shares and sell shares very easily. But in case if a company is not listed, then what is going to happen in that scenario? In that scenario, you will find like that if that company is not listed, then it will be very difficult to sell shares or to buy shares. Talking about a private company, can you sell those shares? No, sirs. We know that as per article of association, the company is restricted from transfer of its shares. So just like that, about this whole scenario, there is a law which is applicable on the security named as security law, which you guys have to cover. I will explain everything about this. And there is one more most important thing, that 100% of examination is going to be there from your notes only. Because we are going to have our classes from the basis of ICSI module. Yes, I will not give any of the classes apart from this module. Whatsoever is over there in this module, we are going to cover that. Now, moving on to next, the law which is going to govern the security is known as security law. There is another part which is going to govern this NSE, BSE, this buy and sell path. That means from listing to trading, that is known as capital market. These things related to capital market and the security law is going to be there in your examination for 70 marks and capital market is going to be in your examination for 30 marks. Got my point? Now, moving on to the main topic. That. This is the legal framework. These are the acts which we are going to cover. So the very first is SCRA, Securities Contract Regulations Act 1956. This is required to be covered along with rules. If I talk about the act now, by the time when I was a student, I was finding this act as boring one, because it is only and only going to tell me about the powers of the government, about the powers of the adjudicating authority. मैं क्या क्या कर सकता हूँ ये तुम्हें बताएगा ये. मैं ये कर सकता हूँ, मैं वो कर सकता हूँ, पर करता कुछ नहीं. After that, we are also going to talk about the case of Subrata Roy Sahara, why he is there into jail. After that, governing issue and listing of securities. How you can issue the securities, how you are going to list the securities. Listing of securities refers to कहाँ पे? OLX पे. OLX पे भेजेंगे हम अपनी कंपनी के. अच्छा, आप एक बात बताओ, the company is company basically comes forward with public issue, so where they are going to sell their shares? OLX पे. फिर कहाँ भेजेंगे? OLX पे नहीं भेजेंगे. अच्छा, फिर कहाँ भेजेंगे? क्विकर पे भेज दें. आजकल फेसबुक पे मार्केट प्लेस आई है, वहां भेज दें. नहीं सर, स्टॉक एक्सचेंज पे भेजेंगे. ओके, लिस्टिंग्स एट स्टॉक एक्सचेंज. Listing at stock exchange. So this is going to be there at stock exchange. After that, the next thing is we are going to talk about SEBI. SEBI is one of the most prominent authorities in India when it comes to the listed companies. What you will find that when it comes to listed companies, everything will be governed by SEBI. When it comes to an unlisted company, definitely that is going to be governed by the company, that the company law itself. But when it comes to listed companies, SEBI will come into picture. When I talk about, if you are giving me an invitation, meri majal hai, main bina uske chala jaun. जस्ट लाइक अ लिस्टेड कंपनी इज देयर सीबी विल ऑटोमेटिकली कम इनटू पिक्चर. कहां जा रहे हो तुम, किसके साथ जा रहे हो, किसकी पार्टी है, क्यों जा रहे हो. So everything just like that, SEBI will put a lot of questions onto that concerned married person, just like her spouse, his spouse, that where you are going, why you are going, when you will be back. You are not going to have peggy shag over there, that means you are not going to drink. What kind of a party is that? I am also going to be there. I mean, I will accompany you for that. So just like that, SEBI is going to put a lot of questions. Now SEBI will take care of you. That is not taking care, man. That is not taken care. Now, Depository Act 1996. Just like that, how many of you have seen that ready movie of Salman Khan? The mother of all banks, the father of all banks, the World Bank. Just like that. We do have a lot of banks, and in every above every bank, we do have RBI. Just like we do have a lot of depository participants. And above them, we have depository. What is depository? What is a depository participant? We are going to cover that later on. But let me tell you, whenever a particular DMAT account is opened, that is opened with a particular DP. You must have heard about a lot of people about the DMAT account. That can be India Bulls, Rally Gear, Sher Khan. So every DMAT account is opened with a kind of depository participant. And this depository participant is going to be under any of the two depositories. Talking about, we do have only two depositories in India, NSDL and CDSL. NSDL, National Security Depository Limited, this is also, I mean, written on your PAN card. Your income tax authority has basically delegated the powers related to section 149, filing of form 49, right, to when you are going to register yourself with that kind of income tax authorities. So the power, that work has been delegated to NSDL. Now, Depositories Act 1996, after that, Depositories Participant Regulations, we are going to combine both of them. Now, after that, moving on to next, sir, what is this? We will be getting these kind of charts every time. I will try to give you these kind of charts every time. As far as I am concerned, as far as these are going to be available, they will be shared. Or else, we are going to note down every aspect. Now. The next thing is all about the SEBI issue of capital and disclosure requirements. SEBI issue of capital disclosure requirements, this is what we call as LODR. So we are going to cover LODR as well. After that, share-based employee benefits. I am going to discuss this in detail as well. This is going to form a part of your syllabus, that what are the benefits which you are giving to your employee. Right, just like the benefit should be like employee entered into the company. There is a person who is going to basically give them a tea or a coffee. What is the requirement? After one hour, the particular refreshment will be offered. After 2 hours, there will be break, lunch break. In the lunch break, they will be allowed to sleep for 1 hour. Wow, such a company, sir. I'm ready to work in that company. And after that, once you are going to wake up, after that they are going to serve you a tea again, or else the people who are looking for, I mean, anything else, refreshment will be given. Then again, work for 2 hours only, and after that, you will be free. Oh, that's my dream job, sir. That's my dream job. If you come to know about any of these companies, please let me know. Yes, there are companies like that, but they are not going to pay you for that kind of a job, right? Now, moving on to next, talking about those kind of things. So, what are the various benefits which are available to the employee? If what is over there when it comes to a listed company is issuing the sweat equity shares. Only these shares can be issued at discount. When it comes to listed company and they are doing buyback, you guys know about buyback, right? Purchase of its own securities by the company itself and destroying them is buyback. After that, prohibition of insider trading. Now, what is termed as insider trading? What do you understand by the term insider trading? Talking about that kind of things, I mean, if you guys, let me give you the exact example. If you are going to be over here, then in that scenario, you know everything about the company. My dear key managerial person, you will know everything about the company. Then when the price of the shares of my company are going to rise and when they are going to fall, you will know everything, that how much profit we have earned in this year and how much dividend we are going to distribute this year. What was the position in the last year and what is the current position at this time? What is going to be our future plan? You will know everything about your company. You are going to have every kind of an information when it comes to your company. But please ensure, if you are going to share, this is all about, you are an insider of the company. You are an insider. That means a person which is there working within the company. I will tell you the exact definition of that as well. You are the insider of the company and the trading, talking about, if you start trading with the shares of the company, then what is going to happen? So that is straight away going to be basically prejudicial to the normal public who is dealing with the shares, or else talking about Ram Babu is not going to have the internal information. Ram Babu is not going to have the internal information about the company, but you do have that internal information. If you start dealing on the basis of that internal information, particularly known as UPSI, unpublished price sensitive information, that means any kind of that information which is going to affect the price. After that, we are going to talk about the SEBI SAS regulations. SAS, kiski SAS? I mean mother-in-law? No. SAS over here refers to takeover. You guys know about that Tata has taken over Jaguar, Range Rover, right? They have acquired. So how the takeover is going to take place, we are going to share a glimpse of that as well. After that, delisting of equity shares. What is delisting? Your company is listed at stock exchange. That never happens, only the shares are listed. So your company is listed at the stock exchange. People are looking at those kind of rates. Do you know how that kind of stock exchange works? Let me show you. So looking over here, what you will find that this is the price of Nifty today. Nifty consists of 50 stock indices, talking about Sensex consists of 30 of them. So this is the price. So you can see over here, let me give you the example about this. Okay, I'm sorry. So I'll just share this with you guys. So you can see the companies, they are written over there at the left. They are written over there at the left. They are listed. That's why they are written over there. If they remove themselves from this listing, then what is going to be the procedure? Or in case there are going to be two instances. There are going to be two instances. That one is termination. That you have the shares of your company were not frequently traded, so they have been basically delisted. Or else something was found which was prejudicial. When it comes to the interest of general public, so that's why the company has been delisted. That's all about the termination, a kind of termination. And there is one thing which we are going to talk about, like that I want to resign. I do not want the shares of my company to be listed. That's it. So in both of the aspects, how the scenario is going to work. After that, we have taken care of everything when it comes to that kind of listing of equity shares, and how we are going to talk about the debt securities. Debt securities, that means udhar. Yes, you are going to issue debentures, or else you are going to issue any kind of other debt securities. Then in that kind of an issue, how the things are required to be dealt with. Now the next is prohibition of unfair trade practices. So that is about the unfair trade practices relating to securities market. If I tell you guys about that, here we are going to talk about the Arshad Mehta scam, what kind of unfair trade practices he has adopted. Now, what are the other things? There are intermediate regulations. These are the different kind of intermediaries which are available, which are going to help your company in listing and in trading as well. So there are going to be a lot of people when it comes to particularly doing any kind of a public issue. They are the people who are going to help you out, right? So there are other regulations as well. Talking about ombudsman, prohibition of fraudulent collective investment scheme. Yes, collective investment scheme is something which you guys have covered into your company law as well. Now let's straight away move on to your syllabus. So this is going to be, sir, what we were covering till date. No, that was just like that it was over there. Module 2, paper 6, security law is going to be there for 70 marks and capital market for 30 marks. Okay, so that is going to be there in your examination. Now talking about that kind of things, that is your syllabus. So part A, security law, first of all, we are going to talk about the Securities Contract Regulation Act 1956. But the interesting portion is this, Contract Regulation Rules 1957. Otherwise, rest of the things, when it talks about definitions from my side will be given as a part of homework, because that is totally a part which is required to be memorized, that is required to be learned. And I will tell you guys that what is the best time to learn those kind of things. Now moving on to next, what is a stock exchange? What is clearing corporation? What is the base? What does it mean by the listing of securities? What does it mean by what are the things which are related to public issue and listing of securities under securities contract? So I'll tell you that how you are going to list your shares, how you are going to list your shares, and after that, how that listing will be continued. After that, we have heard about the same thing so many times, SEBI, who is going to raise your question like your BB, that why, aisa kyun, right? Now moving on to next, objective, powers and functions of SEBI. After that, SAT and scores, there are so many other things which are available. Score is a redressal system, nothing else, my dear student. Yes. Depositories Act 1996. So what kind of a depository system which is over there, which is in India, which is available? After that, what are the functions of depository? What does this depository do basically? What is their work? And after that, what are the depository participants? Who can be, what is the admission of securities? What is dematerialization? Dematerialization, you have guys have covered into your Companies Act section number 23, or if I talk about section 62, when a preferential issue is basically carried on by a listed company, that whenever a particular kind of equity shares they are issued or any kind of securities which are issued, they should be there in DMAT form. That means that they should be there in electronic form. Dematerialization is conversion of physical shares, share certificates into electronic format. Rematerialization is process of conversion of electronic shares into physical share certificates. What is the process of depository inspection and penalty? What is the internal audit, concurrent audit of depository participants? These audits are required to be conducted only by a practicing company secretary. Though chartered accountants can conduct it as well, but this is a recommendation from SEBI that for such kind of things you should hire a practicing company secretary. Now, SEBI, Issue of Capital and Disclosure Requirements 2009, SEBI, LODR, Listing Obligations and Disclosure Requirements, which has replaced the listing agreement, which was between the stock exchange and the companies which are going to be listed at that kind of stock exchange. After that, SEBI, SAST, SAST Regulations 2011, that means how the takeover is going to take place, how the buyback is going to take place. Buyback, we know about buyback, we have covered that in company law. But this is going to be related to a listed company. When it comes to a listed company, the buyback is totally different. But when it comes to other kind of companies, that is totally different. Now, moving on to next, delisting of equity shares. Why the delisting will be done? What is voluntary delisting? And well, voluntary is something when I am my company is going to apply to the stock exchange that I do not want to continue as a part of listed company. I want my shares to be delisted. So that is voluntary. Compulsory is something when an order has been issued by the concerned stock exchange that you just straight away move on. The first thing is get out, or else the second option is may I get out? May I go out please, not get out. So SEBI share based employee benefits, that means what are the various benefits which are available to the employee of a particular company and how they are required to be taken care of. SEBI Issue of Strict Equity Regulations 2002, how you are going to issue. I'm going to talk about every time I'm talking about only a listed company, security law, every time deals with those kind of things, those kind of situations when it comes to a public company. A private company cannot be listed, right? Prohibition of insider trading. So as I told you guys that you are going to have, the person who is sitting next to me is going to have every kind of an information when it comes to company. When it comes to company means you are going to have every kind of an information that how this company is going to deal with that kind of scenarios. If you are going to transfer that information, you might be given lakhs or crores for that. Just passing on an information, and if you are found guilty, then the money which you have earned into three times is going to be the penalty. Or 25 crore, whichever is higher. I will tell you about that and how that calculation is done. Okay, the calculation is too much. I mean, the things are like, oh my god. Now moving on to next, mutual funds. Oh, there are a lot of times what you guys basically come to know about mutual funds. Mutual funds sahi hai, mutual funds sahi hai, that kind of an advertisement is given, is shared a lot of times when it comes to with the telecom media. So mutual funds sahi hai. What is mutual funds and what are the various schemes which are involved? Who are the major players? Who is a sponsor? Who is an asset management company? and trustee, unit holder, how the performance will be evaluated, what is expense ratio, holding period return, net asset value, what are those things which we are going to cover, and mutual fund sahi hai kaise hai. You are going to be a company secretary who is going to tell that yes, mutual fund sahi hai, kaise sahi hai, ye wala mutual fund sahi hai, isme paisa lagao. Kaise lagao? You are going to carry out a lot of things about that. Collective investment scheme, CIS. What is this? Collective investment scheme refers to where a lot of investors came into picture and they are going to basically pool in their investments. They are going to pool in their investments and they are going to invest approximately a sum which is not less than 1000 crores. So they are going to invest that amount, and that using that amount a business activity is going to be carried on, and submission of information and documents, trustees and other obligations. Ombudsman. He's a man his name is Om, and he used to sell that earbuds which are used to clean your ears. Is it like that? No. He is that kind of a person who is appointed so that you are going to file complaint against the government or government agencies to the SEBI ombudsman. Getting my point? So he will tell you about that, how the grievances can be resolved. He will tell you about the award. He will tell you that yes, this kind of things are required to be carried out. This is all about scores. It's a basically a redressal system, nothing else. SEBI information guidance scheme. And ombudsman is that kind of a person who is going to regulate the grievances which you guys have covered, which you guys basically face while dealing with government authorities. Got it? Now, moving on to next point. So these 14 chapters are something which you are going to cover for 7 marks, right? Now, moving on to next, capital market and intermediaries. So what is capital market? Basically, this is what we are going to talk about. Talking about primary market is something where shares are issued. Talking about capital market investment institute, you have heard about this QIB. Qualified institutional buyers, right? After that, foreign portfolio investors, private equity, angel funds, venture capital, pension funds, alternative investment funds. What are they? They turn out to be such kind of basically angels. They turn out to be those kind of people. When a company needs funds, they are going to invest in bulk. They are going to invest in bulk. So let me give you a situation. In case there is a time when you need money. When you need money and your father instantly gives you 5 lakh rupees, le beta, jee le apni zindagi. So in that particular kind of a situation, you are going to be like, wow, my father is the best father in the world. In that kind of situation, they are those kind of people who are going to invest in company in a very bulky amount. Now, moving on to next, capital market instruments. Capital market instruments, that is equities, preference shares, shares with DVRs, differential voting rights, what is a corporate debt, what is non-convertible debenture, what is basically convertible debentures, what kind of they are, partially, fully or optionally. After that, what is FCCB, foreign currency convertible bonds, what is foreign currency exchange bonds, and what is IDR? You have covered ADR, na? You have covered ADR, GDR into section 41 of Companies Act. That a company in India goes abroad and over there they are going to issue shares. And after that, derivatives. What are derivatives? What are warrants? We are going to cover about each and every scenario in very much detail. Aspects of primary market. What is book building? What is ASBA, application supported by block amount? What is green shoe option? Sir, green shoe, gee, what kind of shoes are there? I mean, I don't like green shoes. It's not about the shoes which you are going to wear. It is all about that if you are going to issue shares, the people they are going to apply at your company. What is the assurity that they are? Okay, so let me give you one more situation. You are there into a particular company and your company has issued 1 crore shares and the people who have applied, they are 5 crore. So what is the assurity that everybody will be getting shares? Right, so the assurity is very low. Right, in that situation you are going to get money. The money, the total quantum of money, the quantity of money that has been raised, to 5000 crore rupees. Taking 5000 crore rupees from public and refunding them again, your issue is only of 500 crores that has been oversubscribed 10 times. In that situation, the handling of that money, the bank is not going to do that for free. Come on, he's not your brother-in-law. The jija ji hai, chhod do. Aisa nahi chalega na, beta. So in that situation, he's going to charge you a lot of amount. So there are a lot of aspects that whether how the money can be taken up and how we are going to deal with the rest of the situations related to that. So these are those kind of aspects that how we are going to take the money from the investor and how that is required to be dealt. Now, development of stock secondary market where shares are traded. Where shares or securities, right? The exact term securities are traded. So we are going to talk about the stock market. We are going to talk about the trading mechanism. And after that, we are going to talk about the group block and bulk deals. What is the basis of Sensex? What is Nifty? What are basically the various penalties which are associated? After that, we are going to talk about, okay, risk management in secondary market. We are going to talk about inflation. What is inflation index? What is the credit policy of RBI? Right. So there are so many things which are related to that, which we are going to cover about. That is just a minute topic. This subject will give you marks very easily because you just have to understand the topics. Rest, leave it up to me. I will give you charts for that. What are the secondary market intermediaries? Shares are being traded. So can they be traded on their own, or we will be requiring some kind of effort for that? For that, there are so many intermediaries. You will come to know about merchant bankers, or you must have heard about merchant bankers so many times. There are stock brokers, there are syndicate members, RTA, registrar and share transfer agent. After that, there is a person named as underwriter, bankers to issue, portfolio managers, debenture trustee. Sir, we know about these kind of people, chote chote. Okay, investment advisors, and what is basically, what are the market makers, what are credit rating agencies, CRISIL, ICRA, how basically internal audit of these intermediaries are required to have an internal audit, which is required to be managed by the practicing company secretary. In that particular kind of a scenario, how those things are required to be dealt with. So this is the overall scenario. कि क्या क्या हमको पढ़ना है, that what are the things which we are going to accomplish. Just like I still remember when you guys basically met your first crush. Oh my god, she is my crush, and now I'm going to find out everything about her, whether she is committed or not. I mean, what are her likes and dislikes. So I have given you the whole picture about examination. Jao aur pata lo. I will tell you the techniques as well. Just consider the classroom as love, and let me consider yourself as your friend, not love guru. I'm not going to be like that, right? A company secretary can never be a love guru. I'm very bad at that kind of things. So you just have to crack that part. Ab uska breakup karao, kuch bhi karao, I don't care. But you have to crack the examination. Examination is your crush. After that, once you are having that two words before your name as a prefix, I mean, the life is going to change. The people who are around you, they are going to tell you that, yes, you are a company secretary. Can you please tell me this? The questions might be illogical a lot of time, but you will gain a stage of repute. You will be there at a particular situation of repute. It is not going to be like that people are going to take you casually after that. No. You just have to give them a card, man. There's a CS, da da da. After that, the things are going to work on their own. So looking over here, none of the chartered accountants, none of the company secretaries are aware about these kind of terminologies. None of the chartered accountants, cost accountants, they are not aware about such kind of things. They don't know anything about that as well. Until they are practicing into that. When it comes to company secretary, you guys are only who are going to be there as KMP, who are going to play in market about that. And one more thing. Sir, I would like to put a couple of questions now. Yes, please. The very first question which I have, which book you are going to prefer? Okay. Will you be covering every amendment? Yes. When it comes to amendments, every amendment is required to be taken care of from my end. As far as they are going to be necessary, that will be covered on their own. You need not to worry about anything else. Okay. Great. Sir, who are you, sir? My name is Divay Miglani. I'm company secretary by profession, BCom, NCom, DIPR, and so many others. So leave that, leave that. It's all about that we are going to basically have our classrooms. We are going to have our classrooms. We'll be sharing some live examples. I'll be showing you some kind of live examples that yes, at present the situation of Nifty or the situation of Sensex is like that. Moreover, we'll be talking about the cases which have happened. We'll be talking about the cases of Subrata Roy Sahara. We'll be talking about Arshad Mehta, that how that kind of huge scams that they have ever happened in such kind of cases. Right, we'll be making classes too much simple, and when it comes to book, I'll be focusing on ICSI study material. If you guys have not received the study material, no issues. Whatever I'll be giving you, that is going to form a part of that kind of things. And before proceeding further, amendments will be covered from my end. Please be rest assured about that. And meanwhile, if you, by the time you are studying, you basically came to know about any of the doubts, please let me know. That will be resolved over the WhatsApp or over the call or whatever the kind of situations. Although I'll try my best to start every kind of topic with a very scratch itself. That will give you an advantage, being like, I don't know what kind of an IQ level do you have, but starting everything from scratch will give you the vast knowledge of everything. Whatsoever basically that that brush up is required at your end or any kind of that kind of stuff is required, that will be taken care of totally at my end only. Okay, when it comes to boring topics and there is one thing which I'm assuming about you guys. No, sorry, a couple of things. The very first thing is that you guys don't know about anything. If you know about anything, that's great. The very first thing is that you guys are basically totally bold. You don't know about anything. The next point is that if I'm going to give you a particular question is there in examination. Particular question is there in examination. I will give you points only. I will give you points. You have to explain these points into two, three lines. I basically assume this that my student can do it on its own. Looking at the BCom examination, I mean, I do have that much faith about you, on you guys, that you are going to write 2 to 3 pages on a single line. But here is the point, and you have to explain it properly. That is the only thing. Rest of the things, everything I am going to cover into my classroom only. You need not to study anything else apart from the classrooms. That will be sufficient. Okay. Now, all the best. Bye. Take care of yourself. We'll catch you in next class. See you in classrooms. Bye.